In these tough economic times, you have to watch every dime of your paycheck that you bring home. But who watches the money that you don't bring home and you hand over to your government? Well, now WPBF 25 News does.
All week, we've been taking an in-depth look at public projects and asking, what's that cost?
Tonight, we are taking you on a drive up I-95, where there's been a lot of construction lately.
Including a 2-mile sound wall. What's that cost? If you drive along I-95 in northern Palm Beach County, you know there's a lot of traffic. Alicia DeFago with the Florida Department of Transportation says FDOT is doing something to ease that congestion.
It's imperative that we widen the interstate to keep up with the increase in traffic.
From 6 lanes to 10, and as the traffic increased, so did the sound. Just ask Kimberly Brown.
You couldn't hear each other talk.
She's lived in the northern Palm Beach Heights community for almost a year, just feet from the interstate.
It was very loud. You couldn't have your windows open and get fresh air without the traffic.
Well, Brown's neighborhood is a lot quieter these days. FDOT is finishing a sound wall to block the revving and honking from 95.
Ever since they went up, it's great.
The wall is 22 feet high and stretches about 2 miles from Donald Ross Road to Indiantown Road. Do you have any idea how much this wall costs?
Multi-million dollars, I'm sure.
We asked FDOT, what's that cost? And Brown was right. $5.3 million. Pre-stimulus federal money handed over to the state. Before construction of the wall, this person's pool was just feet from I-95. Now, this community's happy with the wall, but there are some who are not so happy with the cost of this wall.
It's $5.3 million.
Oh, my God. I think that the world is in a terrible place, especially the United States, and we shouldn't be spending money right now.
Why doesn't federal the money. Community that wants it donate the money?
If I lived there, I'd like it, but I don't like my money going to somebody else's problem like that. You know?
DeFago says the wall will affect more than the sound.
This actually will increase the value to some of the homes and stabilize the community economically.
Brown's renting, so that's not her concern. She just wants to be able to open her windows and sleep soundly, no matter the cost.
Worth it for me. Okay. Worth it for me.
Now, each community has to meet several specific criteria to receive a wall. It has to be a new or changed road. The decibels have to be determined unreasonable, and there has to be an adequate benefit to the community, and there are others. Well, FDOT says the grant from the federal government requires them to study the neighborhoods and build a wall alongside communities that meet those criteria. The project is scheduled to be completed by January. And remember, if you're wondering about a public project, program, or a position in your community, head to WPBF.com, find the link in the project economy section, and tell us about it. And we'll ask, what's that cost?
Tomorrow night, we are stopping to smell the roses. Actually, a whole lot of flowers.
In a few months, a new botanical garden will open on the Treasure Coast.
Gardens, I think, are going to be a beautiful natural resource for Port St. Lucie.
20 acres of bright flowers, winding paths, sparkling ponds. Now, construction didn't cost taxpayers a dime, but at a time when Port St. Lucie is cutting 100 city jobs, they now have to pay to run this botanical garden. We ask, what's that cost? The answer tomorrow at 6:00.